Oh. It looks like this basement car caved in some years ago. Something tunneled through here more recently. Like, Christ, what sort of creature makes these markings? Well, spiders. Was that a spider? I don't like spiders. It's a dead dog. Oh, I caught one of the accursed eight-legged beasts nestling in my open mouth when I woke up this morning. In my surprise, I swallowed it. Basically, this guy's been trapped down here and he's been eating the spiders for nutrition. I got a creep under it. Go. Some more. Spiders have been getting bigger and more aggressive. That's about it. If it wasn't for the size of the piece, I would say this looks like an eggshells. That's a pretty fucking big egg then. We've got an earthquake. Worst place to be if there's an earthquake right next to the steam valves. Go, 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 go. Finally, this must be what's left of the basement storage. That looks looked rather worse for wear. Lighter fluid gas. Huzzah! And some batteries. Let's turn that steam valve off. There we are, now I've got a lighter. This way, I think, then this way, then this way. Nope, but I found a ladder. That could come in handy. I've got to go back up there. Now the door is closed. I don't remember closing that door. I think someone's been dragged through here. I've never seen this much blood before. That was my best chance to get some answers. Who else is still down here? The hole isn't large enough for a man, not that I'd go anywhere near it even if it was. What burrowed out this tunnel? Right, well I don't like looking at that, so close the door. And let's follow the blood. A key and a note. 200 days. I've been recovering from a minor operation which I was forced to conduct myself. The procedure itself was elementary enough, a simple amputation of a non-vital organ. I began to notice a thick glue-like substance forming on my tongue. Okay. Day 300, I still hear my aggressive little friend scratching on the door. Thank you. Looks like an internal organ, maybe an animal tongue. That's freaking huge, ugh. And that's creepy. The largest spider I've ever seen with its guts wide open. Okay, let's get out of here. The storage, I've been to the office, now I've got to get to the warehouse. Workshop, sorry, this way. There. Oh god, oh god, oh god. It's locked. Here's the key. God, no. I can fucking... The dogs are coming. All I ever remember from this point to do is to come over here, is grab this, and drag it as soon as I can. Go in here. There we are. There's a cave in, and the whole point of this is to blow it up. I love my workshop. It is great. It is too great a hunting ground to let others gorge their faces. One cannot help but feel for those without some delicate morsel of morsels of which to munch for eight. For Fred ravenously ate. Oh god. And yet mine, whereas mine is working somewhat backwards today. 8, 4, 1, 2. God, right, let's go. 8, 4, 1, 2. Workshop. 8, 4, 1, 2. Maybe if I use some of the string to make a fuge, it looks like a decent enough condition. Brilliant, one step closer to setting off those explosives without losing any vital body parts. Flare, save point. This must be tied into what's going on here. If I keep experimenting, I may discover something useful, or at least have a heart attack. Looks like the hole's at least 3 feet below the surface. The light's been reflected through all the ice. It could just be a piece of ice reflecting the light, or more likely my imagination, but something's definitely catching my eye. It was a pickaxe. My second weapon. Spider webs. Hope that hole was there before the spiders and not the other way around. Electric fence has been put up recently. Better find a way to get across it. It's like a physics engine. Let's try that. Ow! Oh, no. Some wooden planks might help. But I got across. Painkillers. Right, take the battery off. Explosive. This is more like it. Lock, damn it. How am I gonna get in there now? But the door does look very old and weak. Like that, I guess. Four more painkillers. That'll come in useful. Dynamite. Oh my goodness. Perfect. A gunpowder keg. There's only a small hole in the top, though, not big enough to reach in. So we smashy. Dry gunpowder, that's what I need. So if I. It's soaked in Baxton, so the gunpowder should stick, or rather, I shall pray the gunpowder sticks. Right, with any luck, one fuse ready to go. Right, now I've got the lighter, I've got the dynamite, and I've got the fuse. So let's go. Save it though. God knows what's gonna happen. I may never get used to that. Right, let's go before we alert any of the dogs. Turn the flashlight off. I don't see anything. Right, fuse. And lighter. Fuse is running faster than I thought. Gotta take cover. Let's go. When I look back, I can't think what spurred me to go deep into the mine. Perhaps it was arrogance at still being alive, or something as ridiculous as facing adversity and coming out on top. Now I know I should have been better off starving, or being mauled to death, than kick-starting the chain of events that led me to end up here, writing to you. I just hope, once you understand my story, you will have what's necessary to put an end to this tale. I certainly didn't. Power room. I would like some power. Well, the noises down here are so alien compared to the way things sound on the surface. The rock floor almost sounds organic, like rock moving.